Hi, and welcome to this week's episode on the Academy. My name is Finola, and I'm part of the customer success team here at Pulsate. This week, we're going to look at how you can get more signups in your app by using an onboarding flow. So let's get into it. So why should you use an onboarding flow for your app? It's a great way to welcome new users and to highlight the main features within your app and show them how they can complete key tasks. There's many different ways that you can onboard, such as using preview screens. We're going to talk about them today, and also the learn by doing method, which is more of an interactive kind of onboarding. We're going to look at that in another video in a week or two. Video onboarding is another option that you can use, and that's quite like the video that some apps present in the App Store. And also, some use a combination of all three. If you take a look at the Headspace app, they use the learn by doing, the video onboarding, and they show a few static screens as well. But it's about getting the balance right here and not having too many screens so that your onboarding flow is quite long, because your users are going to get fed up at that stage and opt out and never go into your app again. So looking at the preview screens, this is basically, as I mentioned there, a static screen or like a screenshot, also known as coach screens. So they reinforce the value of your app and they highlight the key benefits. And these are usually about three or four screens are best. So we're going to look now at the Duolingo app. They use four static screens when you enter into the app. And the first one presents the value proposition of the app, which is free language for the world. And they also have a button at the end of it saying get started, or if you already have an account, you can sign in there. But if you move on, they show the four dots as well, which is great because you know how many screens there are. You can see your progress. And the second page lets you know kind of what's in the app, learning gamified. They show some of the icons that they use, and then screens three and four show you how you get your progress by earning hearts, and they show your achievements as well. So if you do tap on the get started button, then this is like a learn by doing kind of method with onboarding, but just not to go into too much detail on that, as we will be looking at that in another video. But if you tap get started, then you're straight into using the app. You can choose the language that you want to learn. You can set your goals. So whether you want to learn by doing 5, 10, 20 minutes per day, and then you can choose the path as well, whether you're a beginner or an advanced learner. So you're straight into your first lesson then, learning a new language, and you can only when you complete a level do they ask you, would you like to sign up for the app? So that's really clever on Duolingo's part there, as you're quite invested in the app at that stage. So that was one of the ways of how you can get more signups for your app by looking at the static screens today. So next week we'll be looking at the signup screens in the onboarding flow in the customer lifecycle journey. So be sure to subscribe to the Academy if you haven't done so already. Leave us a comment below or catch us on Twitter at PulsateHQ. See you next time. Hi, and welcome to this week's episode of the Academy.
My eyelashes stuck to the bottom ones there, so that's good.